Hey everybody, in this video we're going to continue our discussion on solutions by talking about solution stoichiometry. So if you are unfamiliar with stoichiometry or you need a little something to refresh your understanding of stoichiometry, then please feel free to click that annotation right up there and that will take you to my video that is called What is Stoichiometry? So again, assuming that we have a fairly decent understanding of stoichiometry, well now that we can discuss it, in the context of solutions. So remember, stoichiometry, well, that is the branch of chemistry that is concerned with the numerical relationships between reactants and products in chemical reactions. And stoichiometry uses balanced chemical equations, and those balanced chemical equations basically serve as recipes. They tell you how many of each reactant that you have to put in, and they tell you how many of each product that you have to get out. So let's see if we can't sort of intermingle the knowledge that we have with stoichiometry in the context of aqueous solutions. So the basic scheme in how most solution stoichiometry problems work is, let's say we have a simple reaction with one reactant that I'm going to call A and one product that I'm going to call B. And the idea is that we want to convert from the volume of solution A all the way to the volume of solution B. Now we can't do that directly. In other words, there's no one-step conversion that's going to take us from the volume of A to the volume of B, but we can actually accomplish it using a three-step conversion process that I'm going to highlight for you right now. So again, we're trying to go from the volume of A all the way to the volume of B. And we can't go there directly. Well, the first thing that we could do is we can convert from the volume of A to the amount of A in moles. And we can use the molarity of solution A, assuming that we know the molarity of solution A. We can use it to accomplish this conversion from volume to moles. Now, the reason why we need to convert to moles is because the mole is the unit that is compatible with a balanced chemical equation. Right? Because chemical equation doesn't say anything about mass, doesn't say anything about volume. It's talking about moles. It tells you how many moles of each reactant that you put in, and it tells you how many moles of each product that you get out. So it's necessary in order to use a balanced chemical equation. We have to convert to moles. So now that we have the amount of A in moles, well, we can convert that all the way to the amount of B in moles, and it's the coefficients from the balanced chemical equation that are going to help us accomplish this part of the conversion process. Notice that the coefficients in front of A and B are both an understood one, so this step would be very, very easy for this particular example, but it's not always going to be that easy, so this conversion step here is definitely necessary. And now that we have the amount of B in moles, well, we can convert that into the volume of B. Now we're going to use the molarity of B to accomplish that conversion. So again, it's a three-step conversion process that requires three conversion factors. So you go from volume of A to the amount of A to the amount of B to the volume of B. Three steps, three conversion factors, two of them are molarity, and then this one in the middle here uses coefficients from the balanced chemical equation. So let's go ahead and do an example. So this problem says, what volume in liters of 0.854 molar NaOH solution is required to react completely with 2.10 liters of a 0.972 molar BaCl2 solution according to the balanced chemical equation below? So the balanced chemical equation says we have 2 NaOH plus BaCl2 yields 2 NaCl plus Ba and then OH parenthetically subscript 2. So what we're going to do is we're going to start by writing out the volume of the solution that we know the most about. So notice that we know the molarity of the sodium hydroxide, the NaOH, but we know both the molarity and the volume of the BaCl2. So we know more about that. So I'm going to start by writing out the volume of the BaCl2 solution, which is 2.10 liters of BaCl2. Now that I have that volume written down, well, I can easily convert that from liters to moles of BaCl2, and I'm going to use the molarity as my conversion factor to accomplish this conversion. So remember, molarity, or that capital M that you see there, is nothing more than the amount of solute in moles over liters of solution. So that means that for every 1 liter of this BaCl2 solution, we're going to have 0.972 moles of BaCl2 dissolved within that solution. So this conversion factor Makes a lot of sense. It's a valid conversion factor to go from volume to moles. Now that we have the amount of BaCl2 in moles, we can convert that into the amount of NaOH in moles using the coefficients from this balanced chemical equation. So you put the coefficient for BaCl2 on the bottom, which it, of course, is an understood 1, and then we're going to put the coefficient for NaOH, which is a 2, on the top of this conversion factor. So we have accomplished 2 of the 3 steps that we need. The only thing remaining that we have left to do is to simply convert from moles of NaOH to liters of NaOH using the molarity of the NaOH solution. So it says we have a 0.854 molar NaOH solution. That means that for every 1 liter of NaOH, we're going to have 0.854 moles of NaOH. So this can easily be written out as a conversion factor in which we put the 0.854 moles of NaOH on the bottom and then 1 liter of NaOH on the top. Now, before we go reaching for that calculator, we want to make sure that all of the units except for liters of NaOH cancel out. So it looks like liters of BaCl2 cancel, it looks like moles of BaCl2 cancel, and it looks like moles of NaOH cancel. So we are in the right ballpark, so to speak. So after crunching this into a calculator, the result that I obtain, it's going to be kept to 3 significant figures. It's going to be 4.78 liters of 0.854 molar NaOH. So that is solution stoichiometry in a nutshell. It's quite similar to the mass-to-mass conversions that we did a few videos back when we were talking about stoichiometry. Instead of going from mass to moles using molar mass, we're going from volume to moles using molarity as our conversion factor. So I hope this video helped you out a little bit. If you have any questions, make sure to submit a comment. And all right, that's it. You guys have a great day.